Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will solve some of the problems related to operational amplifiers. Before going to solve some of the problems, we will look at the different formulas related to operational amplifiers. Now, first one. In the case of inverting amplifier, we will give input to the inverting terminal, that is represented by number 2, and another terminal which is called as non-inverting terminal, represented by plus, is grounded. And this operational amplifier 741C is connected to 12 volt dual power supply. And we will look at the output voltage at the terminal 6 and with respect to ground, where RF is the feedback resistor and Rin is the input resistor. Vin is the input voltage. Vin may be AC signal or DC voltage. Now, voltage gain of this inverting amplifier can be defined as, it is the ratio of output voltage to the input voltage. It is represented by AV. For the case of inverting amplifier, voltage gain is equal to minus RF divided by R1, that is, voltage gain is the ratio of feedback resistance to the input resistance, where negative sign represents if an AC signal is given as input to the inverting amplifier, then the phase difference between output and input voltage is 180 degrees. Or if you provide positive DC voltage at the output, we will receive negative output voltage. Next, for non-inverting amplifier, we will apply input in the terminal 3, that is called as non-inverting terminal, and 2 is called as inverting terminal as in the previous case, and this 741C op amp is connected to 12 volt dual power supply, and RF is the feedback resistor, Rin is the input resistor, Vin is the input. And we will measure output at 6 with respect to ground. Now we will look at the voltage gain formula for non-inverting amplifier. As in the previous case, AV is equal to V out divided by V in. For the case of non-inverting amplifier, it is given by 1 plus RF divided by R1. AV is equal to 1 plus RF divided by R1 is the voltage gain for non-inverting amplifier. Next, we will look at the adder circuit or summing amplifier circuit in inverting mode. For that, we will provide 3 inputs. We can give any number of inputs. In this case, we are providing 3 inputs. They are represented by V1, V2, V3, and they are sent through the resistors R1, R2, R3 to the inverting terminal 2, where RF is the feedback resistor and R is the resistance through which the non-inverting terminal is grounded. As in the previous case, 741C op amp connected to 12 volt dual power supply, output is measured at the 6 with respect to ground, at the terminal 6 with respect to ground. Now we will look at the output of the adder circuit or summing amplifier circuit. That is given by V out is equal to minus RF into V1 by R1 plus V2 by R2 plus V3 by R3. This is not the exact formula for summing amplifier or op amp adder. In order to make this as adder circuit, we need to give some condition. That condition is given by RF is equal to R1 is equal to R2, that is equal to R3. If you substitute this, we will get V out as minus of V1 plus V2 plus V3. Since we have given input to the inverting terminal, we are getting minus sign here. That is, in case of inverting mode, output of a adder circuit is minus of the sum of the inputs. If we give inputs to the non-inverting amplifier, we will get V out as sum of inputs. Now we will solve problems related to operational amplifiers. First one, for an inverting amplifier, R1 is equal to 10 kilo ohm, RF is 50 kilo ohms. What is the output voltage for an input of 4 volts? Let us solve this problem. Let us write given data, that is, input resistor R1 is given as 10 kilo ohms, kilo means 1000 or 10 power 3. If you multiply 10 by 10 power 3, we will get 10 into 10 power 3 ohms. This is R1. RF is given as 50 kilo ohms. It is equal to 50 into 10 power 3 ohms. Input voltage supplied is 4 volts. We are asked to find out output voltage in case of inverting amplifier. We know that for an inverting amplifier, voltage gain is given by ratio of output voltage to the input voltage, that is equal to minus RF divided by R1. In order to calculate Vout, we have already RF, R1 and Vin. LHS of these two equations are same. We will equate these two. We will get Vout by Vin is equal to minus RF by R1. Then, rearranging for Vout, we will get Vout is equal to minus RF divided by R1 into Vin. Now substitute all the values for RF, R1 and Vin, we get minus of, in the place of RF I have substituted 50 into 10 power 3 divided by 10 into 10 power 3 for R1 and I have substituted 4 for Vin. 10 power 3 gets cancels. 10 5s are 50, 5 into 4 is 20. Output voltage Vout is given by Vout is equal to minus 20 volts. This is the required solution we are asked to find out. Let us move on to the next problem. In the circuit of non-inverting operational amplifier, determine the output voltage if R1 is equal to 2 kilo ohm, RF is equal to 10 kilo ohm, Vin is equal to 2 volts. Let us solve this problem. Since we are asked to find out output voltage in the non-inverting operational amplifier, we have to use the formula which is related to non-inverting operational amplifier. Let us list out the given data. R1 is given. R1 is given as 2 kilo ohms, that is equal to 2 into 10 power 3 ohms. RF is given as 10 kilo ohm, that is 10 into 10 power 3 ohms. Input voltage is given, it is 2 volts. We are asked to find out output voltage. Let us write the formula for voltage gain in general. In the case of non-inverting amplifier, AV, voltage gain, is given by 1 plus RF divided by R1. Since LHSs are same for these two equations, we will equate these two. We will get V out by V in as 1 plus RF by R1. Since we are asked to find out V out, I will rewrite this expression for V out. We will get V out is equal to 1 plus RF by R1 into V in. That is, V out is equal to 1 plus, in the place of RF I have substituted 10 into 10 power 3, in the place of R1 I have substituted 2 into 10 power 3, V in is equal to 2 volts, I have substituted it, 10 power 3 gets cancels, 2 5s are 10, 5 is left in this expression, 5 plus 1 is 6, 6 into 2 is 12, that is, output voltage is equal to 12 volts for the given values of R1, RF, Vin in the case of non-inverting operational amplifier. In this way, we have calculated output voltages for inverting and non-inverting operational amplifier. Let us move on to next problem. To an op-amp adder circuit, 3 input voltages of 3 millivolt, 4 millivolt and 5 millivolt are supplied through resistors of 10 kilo ohm, 20 kilo ohm and 30 kilo ohm respectively. If RF is equal to 120 kilo ohm, calculate the output voltage. In this problem, we are asked to find out output voltage in the case of op-amp adder circuit. Students, listen here. I have explained this adder circuit. We are providing three inputs, V1, V2, V3, which are different. V1 is passed through R1, V2 is passed through resistor R2, V3 is passed through resistor R3. Now, in this problem, we are given with V1 as 3 millivolts, V2 as 4 millivolts, V3 as 5 millivolts, with R1 as 10 kilo ohm, R2 as 20 kilo ohm, R3 as 30 kilo ohms, and RF is given as 120 kilo ohms. So that we have to use the formula Vout is equal to minus RF into V1 by R1 plus V2 by R2 plus V3 by R3 because we are given with different R1, R2, R3 as well as RF. Let us solve this problem using the given data. R1 is 10 kilo ohm, that is 10 into 10 power 3 ohms. R2 is 20 kilo ohm, that is 20 into 10 power 3 ohms. R3 is 30 kilo ohm, that is 30 into 10 power 3 ohms. RF is 120 kilo ohm, 120 into 10 power 3 ohms. V1 is 3 millivolts, milli means 10 power minus 3. If I multiply that, I will get V1 as 3 into 10 power minus 3 volts. V2 is 4 millivolt, that is 4 into 10 power minus 3 volt. V3 is 5 millivolt, that is 5 into 10 power minus 3 volt. We are asked to find out output voltage in the case of op-amp adder circuit. Now I will use output voltage formula for op-amp adder circuit in case of inverting mode, that is given by Vout is equal to minus RF into V1 by R1 plus V2 by R2 plus V3 by R3. If you substitute for V1, R1, V2, R2, V3, R3 and RF, I will get this. By calculating this term, we will get Vout is equal to minus of 120 into 10 power 3 into 10 into 10 power 3 is 10 power 4. If we take this to numerator, we will get 10 power minus 3 into 10 power minus 4, that is 3 into 10 power minus 7 plus 20 can be written as 2 into 10, that is 2 into 10 power 4. Therefore, 2 to the 4, that becomes 2 into 10 power minus 7. Here, 30 can be written as 3 into 10, that is 3 into 10 power 4. Or if we take 10 power 4 to numerator, we will get 10 power minus 7. 5 by 3 is nothing but 1.67. Therefore, 1.67 into 10 power minus 7. If we add this, we will get 6.67 into 10 power minus 7. If we multiply with 120 into 10 power 3, we will get the output voltage as 80.04 into 10 power minus 3 volts, or it can be written as 80.04 millivolts. Students, in this lecture we have calculated output voltages in case of inverting amplifier, non-inverting amplifier as well as op-amp adder circuit or summing amplifier circuit. For summing amplifier circuit, if we use non-inverting mode, we will get plus sign here. If we use inverting mode, we will get minus sign here. Thank you.